Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Today, we're going to manually tag a list within a PDF. The document on my screen has a list item with a nested list inside of it. And I went ahead and deleted the tags out of the tags panel so that we can re-tag it. The first step that I want to do is right-click in my tags panel and select New Tag. Then I'm going to add a list tag. I can use the drop-down menu or simply type a capital L and select OK. This creates a blank tag for me. Now, lists have unique tag structures, and I'm going to manually create some of them for my placeholders. So as it stands now, we have one list item, four list items, and a second list item on my main list. But before we get to that, take a moment to hit that like and subscribe button. Now back to the video. Let's first create two list items. I'm going to right click the L tag and select New Tag. Then I'm going to type LI, a capital LI, for list item. And then we're gonna create another one. I'm going to right click the list item tag, select New Tag, and select OK. This begins to build a structure for my tag type. Now I can move these two LI items inside of my list tag. Now let's get an L body tag. This is the next required component. We could also add a label tag if we want. Let's go ahead and add both of those. So I'm going to right click the LI tag, select New Tag, and let's type LBL. And then let's do it again for the other tag. And now we need two L bodies inside also. Next, I can begin to build the tag tree a little better by dragging and dropping these tags into their appropriate locations. So each LI tag gets a label tag and an L body tag. Now what I can do is I'm going to select the first LBL element in my tags tree, and then I'm going to highlight this bullet in my document, go to the options panel in the tags pane, and select create tag from selection. This puts the bullet inside of my label tag and is already correct. Next, I'm going to select my L body tag and then select the text from this first body tag. Then under the options menu from the tags pane, I'm going to select create tag from selection. This puts all of that text inside of the correct location within this list item. Let's go ahead and do the same thing. All right, we're gonna go ahead and do the next list item, and I'm gonna do the same technique. I'm first going to select that LBL tag from my tags tree, and then I'm going to select the bullet from the document, go to the options menu from the tags pane, and select create tag from selection. Again, this creates the bullet, and because I'm selecting the tag while I highlight the text, it's telling the computer exactly where to put this tag when I select create tag from selection. That one didn't seem to work, so let's try that again. There we go. So now I have my two list items and they're properly formatted. The next thing I need to do is create a list for my bulleted sublist. Now this is a little more complicated, but essentially I need to create a new list tag structure inside of my L body tag of that first bullet. To do that, I'm going to select the L body tag from the tags tree, right click, select new tag, and type the letter L for a list tag. I'm then going to nest this list tag inside of the L body tag. From here, I'm going to create four list items because I have four list items in my nested list. And then we can move all of these inside of the L parent tag. Next, we need the label and L body for each one of these. So I'm going to create my label tags, four of them, and then we're going to create our L body tags for each one of these list items. And then we are going to place them into the right spot. So each LI tag gets an L body and an label. And I'm just dragging these tags into the correct location. So each one of the LI tags now has the correct structure. Now we can begin to do the create tag from selection to get all of this content into the right spot. All right, let's move on to the second label. I am clicking inside of the options menu. create tag from selection, and moving down the list. And after you do this for a long time, it starts to become second nature, and you can just fly through the document pretty quick. All right, we have one more list item to do, and then we'd be done. Okay, I think that's everything. Let's review. So I just manually created a list item using the create tag from selection option from within the tags pane. I have a list with two list items, and the first list item has a nested four item list where the labels and the text have been tagged. Let's go ahead and run the accessibility checker just to see if we did things correctly. It looks like we're missing one piece of content, and we can fix that by using the reading order tool. Oh, you know what? Let me go back to my tags panel. It's possible I just missed some text. So what I can do is select all of the text again and then create tag from selection once more. And let's see if that fixed it. Nope, I'm still missing. All right, it looks to be just a blank space. So I'm going to select it and select background artifact. And then let's run that checker one more time. And now we have a mostly accessible document. The next step would be to take this into the PAC 2021 tool. But the purpose of this video was to manually create a list item in Adobe Acrobat Pro. As always, thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.